in the last class we had stopped over here. We were doing this question for managing a student management system where we had to perform these series of operations: insert, display, searching, update, deletion. So we had completed three of them: insertion, display, student lookup. So I'll just scroll through the beginning. This was the insert function where we had to first open the file in the append mode, append plus read mode, and that too for binary files. And then we created an empty list, that is record, asked for the names, class, section, the data values from the user, added them to to this record list. Okay, we created a list and we added all these values to this list, dump them in a file, continue this till the user wants, and finally close the file. In the next function, that is display, this was created to display all the records of all the students, and we had used pretty table in this. So this process is quite straightforward. All you need to do is just these extra lines you have to add your records to the pretty table. So within the try and accept block, we have to write the code. So try, then while true, read a record from the file, add it to the pretty table. And when the EOF is reached in the file, at that time, print your pretty table and close the file. Same way for lookup, that is for searching also, we had opened the file in the read mode. We had to first search, we had to first read the record, see whether the first element of second element of the record, that is one with the index one, is S name or not, because the first element would be roll number, second element would be student name, third class, and so on. Okay, so over here we have record one, so one represents student's name. So if a match is found, add that to the pretty table, print the pretty table, and break, because we will be having only one record with the student name. Later on, we would replace this searching with a student name with searching with a roll number. Now, it could also be possible that two or more students have the same name. So in that case, you will not use break. Instead, you will be searching till the end. Okay, keep on adding the records to your pretty table and do not print it over here. Print it over here. That is in EOF. And you can also use a boolean variable to see whether the record has been found or not, so that we can keep on modifying it from time to time. Now today what we are going to see is update and deletion. So let me explain the technique which we are going to use for update. Now usually in binary files, what happens is we have to first read all the records in a list, perform all our updations in that list, and finally dump that list back to the file. So we would be reading all the records of the file in a list first. We would be performing our update operations from the within the list, and finally this updated list we will be dumping back to the file. How we'll be doing that, we'll be seeing it in a short while. We'll let whiteboard open. The very first thing which we are going to do is number one, read all records from disk file and store in a list. So we will be storing all the records in a list, right? Second, we are going to provide a menu to the user provide update menu to user. What this menu should contain? Except roll number, it should provide the user the facility to update anything. Update student name, update class, update section, update marks. It should provide the user the facility to update any of these things. And this thing should be within a loop. Okay, again and again, provide this and give ordinal numbers to these. And ask for the user, what is the choice? Okay, if the user says one, because it is not necessary that every time user will be updating every value. Maybe user only wants to change the class. Maybe the user only wants to change the marks. So we have to give the user a loop, a menu to change individual data items in a record. So if the user says S name, then it will give the user a choice to enter new value for S name. Okay. And once the user has entered the required value, what it will be doing is, it will be changing. Now, before this, I have missed one step. So this would be our step three, actually. This thing has to be step three because step two we have missed. In step two, we have to search for the record to be updated. And this searching will be done where? By again reading from the disk file, or will it be done in the list which we have created? Obviously, it will be done in the newly created list, which contains all the records from the database. Okay. So now, after this is done, that is, we have searched for the record. After we have asked for what values the user wants to update, you will be making changes, or you will modify the updated, sorry, modify the matched record. The record which you found. Okay, suppose we have been storing the matched record in record. So this record will contain all the data values, that is S name, roll number, S name, class, section, marks. So within that, we will be making changes over here. How will we make the changes? It would be done something like this, like record one equals new S name. This new S name is the new student name which we asked from the user. So you will simply write record one equals new S name. Okay. Record two means class equals new class. And so on. So you will be making changes this way. So whenever you are asking for a new S name, you will include this statement also. Immediately you will replace the name within record. So at the end of this loop, when the user presses back or exit, what will happen? This record will have been modified. So already this modified record is there. Now what you need to do is you need to replace the record within the list which we had created. This list creates individual lists, where each of the lists represents a record which is there in your disk file. Okay, so what will happen? This record, suppose this was the matched record. So it has been already updated over here. Okay, the matched record has been updated, or maybe you created a copy of the record. So you have to make sure that it gets updated here. Once this matched record is updated, that means this list is ready to go back into the file. So what you will be doing is, you will be opening the file in write mode, such that it replaces all the content of the file. It removes all the previous content of the file, and you will write, or you will dump the list to the file. this list which you have created, this you will be dumping to the file. So this way you can update records. So let me tell you that updation of records is quite tricky when it comes to flat files. And right now we are using flat file systems. This thing is very easy in case of databases, as you have already seen in the connectivity chapter. Okay. Only thing, because databases don't follow sequential access, they follow random access. Randomly we can pick up, we can search for a record in the database, we can update its value. We just have to provide a query update using the update command. Okay, update table set field equals to value, comma field equals to value, and so on, where such condition has been satisfied. So all you need to do there is just to provide a query, and your record will get updated easily because it follows random access, whereas flat file is based on sequential access, where all the records are accessed sequentially. That is, if you want to reach the fifth record, you have to first traverse through first, second, third, and fourth record, and then only you will be reaching the fifth record. So this is the technique which we are going to follow in case of updation, right? So let's go back to our program and let's start coding the function for updation. So we will be creating the function over here, def update. Update what? Again, ask for S name. On this time, let us do it based on roll number, right? So we will update the student's record based on roll number. So first thing, we have to open the file. Okay, which mode we will be opening the file in? Because the very first thing is, we have to read everything from the file. Sabse pehle to file se sab kuch hume read karna hai. Right? So we will be opening the file in the read mode only. And let us create a student database, that is a student table which will contain all the records of the students, right? So we will be writing student equals pickle.load. Will load all the student records in the file. Okay, I use the wrong method. Wait. Student equals list. First, create an empty list which will store all student records. So this is an empty list which we have created. Now we are going to wait. Let me make it a little visible for you all. Now we have to open the try block. While true, what is the statement which we are going to write? We have to read everything in a variable. So let us take a variable record equals pickle.load file. And this record we will be adding to student. Student.append record. Fine. We'll continue doing this till the accept block is activated. And when EOF error is there, you don't need to do anything. So you can just type pass and come out, right? So this is the file, or you can also alternatively try to print all the values. So now we have read all the records in the file. Close the file, because we had opened the file in which mode? Read mode. Now we will be closing the file in the read mode, and later on we will be opening the file in the write mode. So now everything is there within the student list. So this student list is a list which contains individual list items. It is actually a list which contains individual list items. It is an outer list, and inside we have all the inner lists. Something like this. So it will be easy for us to work with these individual lists. Now what we need to do is we need to perform the first step is done. We need to perform the second one, search for the record to be updated. So for searching the record, now because file was already opened in the read mode, I will remove close from here, and what I will be doing is just I will be typing file.seek 0. No, I don't need to do this. Sorry students, please wait. Second is search for the record. Now search for the record based on what? Based on roll number, because you can see over here we are asking for the roll number of the student whose record is to be searched. So we will be writing we take it as record only. If record and the first value of the record is equal to roll number, that is, if the roll number part is equal to roll number entered by the student, that means a match is found. Now what to do for a match is found? We need to save this record. So I'm going to save the record in a variable named mrec, which stands record. So students, are you able to hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
For some time there was some problem because somebody called on my mobile, and right now I have logged in using my cellular network. Somebody called and the internet connection, it just got interrupted. One second. Okay. Yes. So here it is. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to also save the record number, because I need to know which record is being updated, so that at the end I can simply update, I can simply replace that particular record with the changed matched record. Okay. So this one would be 0, this one would be 1. 2 and 3. Each of these individual list items, individual outer list items, which are lists themselves, they have to be provided these numbers. That is, they already contain these indices. So we are going to save the index of the matched record. Suppose the matched record is this. So we are not only going to save this record, we are also going to save its index. So let us save the index in a variable mrecno, that is record number. So I will be saving it as I. And once this search is done, I'm going to break. I can alternatively also do something like I can also save this. I can also display this particular record. So I'm going to simply write print record. So it will print this record, so that I also get to understand that yes, this is the record which I am searching for, and this is what I have to update. So once this is done, we can break. Okay. And just need to make sure of something. If suppose your record is not found, what will we be doing in that case? So I'm taking mrec equals none, and mrecno also I'm going to take it as none. Okay, so in case your record is not found, these both will remain as none only. Now in the next step, you are going to make changes, right? So first you have to check whether there is something in mrec or not. If mrec is if MREC contains some value, that means we have some record in the match record. So now we will be giving a loop and to the user, a menu to the user. So I'm using while true, print. Update record. First, update what student name. You will not give the user the facility to change the roll number because roll number is something which is unique to all the students. You should not give the user the facility to change the roll number. So except roll number, we are going to change everything else. Update class. Update section. Update marks. And the final option will be back. Okay, so this is the update menu. Now I am going to ask for the choice of the user, what user wants. Enter your choice. Now, if choice is equal to 1, that means update student name, provide pass everywhere, first letters. Always you should first create the outer structure. Next is update class, pass, elif choice equals 3. This will be update section, pass. Elif choice 4, update marks, and else it has to be break. That is break the loop so that this entire update part is terminated. Okay, so now what we have to do over here, we have to ask for a new student name. So I'm just providing new sname equals input. Enter the new student name. And this thing I'm going to send to record. So record. Now student name is the second item. So record one equals, or is it going to be record one, or we will be doing it for MREC. MREC one, because MREC contains the matched record. MREC one is equals to new sname. Fine. Can you complete these statements over here? Let me ask any of you. You have to complete the statements for updating class, section, and marks. Just like ask for a new value and update that value in the record. The record contains everything in this order. First roll number, then S name, then class, then section, then marks. Okay, so here you can see roll number is, its index is 0, and rest every index has been provided over here. So who is going to tell me? Ask for you can ask for access over my computer and I'll give you the access and you can type it directly on my screen. Okay, Pradyum, you had done it last time. Why not Chirag? Chirag, are you there?
No, I am to my mobile, not with the PC.
Okay, anyone else who has logged in using the computer? Raise your hands. Only Pradyum. Okay, doesn't matter. Yes, Pradyum, you can ask for this. Yes, so we will be asking for a new class. and that will go into MREC. Let's see what Pradyumna types for MREC. So it will be 2, index 2 will be class. Similarly, index 3 will be section, index 4 will be marks. So we'll take new section for the updated section. Very good, Pradyum. So you can see how we are going to make changes in the matched record. Matched record is already with us, so we are making changes in the matched record. Okay. So we can make changes in the match record. Now, this was the match record. Let me just give a name here. Matched record index. So now everything has been done. Our matched record is ready, that is MREC. And now what we need to do is we need to make the change. We need to highlight the change in the main thing. So let me go back and let's reflect on which step we have completed. We have searched for the record. We have provided an update menu to the record. Okay. We have also modified the matched record. Yahan tak humne complete kar liya hai. The record which was matched, we even modified that, right? Now, what we need to do is we have to modify. One step is missing over here. That is, we have to modify the outer list. That is the student list. So for this, it would be modify the or replace the old record in student list with new record. So we have to update that record. So what was our original list? It was student. So in this student list, we had read all the records. That is, this was it, the outer list, which you can see over here, which contained all the individual records in the form of lists. So this student list we are going to update. And how will we update? We need to know the index also. Where is the index? It is already stored in MRECNO. So all I need to do is just type a statement like this, student MRECNO. Now, let me see. Student MRECNO, that will be equal to what? The new record. So MREC. Do you understand? Student MRECNO. MRECNO contains the index of the match record, and MREC contains the match record which we have modified. And now we have to replace this old record with this match record. So because student is a list, we can easily do that. So now our student list contains the updated record. We can easily write it back to the file. So I have already closed the file in the read mode, and now I will be updating the file. Type dump the updated record into the file. So how to do that? Again, open the file. And this time I will be opening that in the write mode. So WB format, we will be opening the file in that. And individually, I'm going to write everything. So I will be typing for record in student. Article dot dump record comma file. So with this file is updated. We have updated our file successfully, and now at the end we will be checking whether all the records have been updated or not. Now you might be thinking, why can't we dump the entire list? The thing is, in originally we had saved everything in the file in the form of individual lists. My file exactly contains this thing. This is my disk file. It contains individual records, which are lists. And each of them is considered as a separate object. If I dump the entire student list is a list of lists. So what will happen in that case? It will be considered, it will be dumped in the form of one whole object, which we will have to read in one go in the when we run the program next time. So we have to avoid doing this. That's why we have to now pick out individual lists from that list and write them as separate list objects into the file. That is the reason why I have used this loop for doing so. Let us check whether our code is working fine or not. Sometimes it needs a lot of hit and trial. So we will just see whether it is working fine or not. Okay. So for that, we have to first ask for roll number from the user. So we will ask the roll number. Enter the roll number of the student. To modify it. It should be student whose record is to be modified. Otherwise, it would just change the name. Okay. I made a mistake, forgot one closing bracket. And now we will be just calling the function. Let's check the name. It is simple update. So update, and we are sending what? Roll number. And if the updation is successful, now we had done something, if you remember. If MREC. Okay, so that means I'll have to place everything within this. If MREC, the match record, is found, then only all this has to be done. If suppose the match record is not found, then your program should simply print, sorry, record doesn't exist. All this updation you can do only when the matched record is there in the file. Okay, if the record is not there in the file, then you won't be able to perform. It will try to update, but there is nothing in MREC. Okay, why? Because we have searched for the record. If there is nothing in MREC, what will you be updating? Okay, so that is why only if update, only if MREC contains valid data. Only when MREC contains valid data, we have to perform updation. Otherwise, we will simply print record doesn't exist. And after making changes, after updating, you should give a statement. Record updated successfully. All this is, it comes under good programming practice, because you are making the software for someone else. Okay, so you should make it as user friendly as possible, provide comment lines and provide prompts wherever necessary. Let's run the program. So first we will display all the students. So these are the records of all the students, and I would like to update the class of Jenna B, whose roll number is 4. So I'm going to press 4. enter the roll number. So I've entered the roll number as 4, and yes, it gave me the correct, it found the correct record. And now I have to update what class. So for class, I will be entering my choice, that is 2. New class, simple 11th I want. Okay, enter. I don't want to change anything else. Now let's see if it has been changed or not. So yes, it has been changed. Let's try to update anything else. Okay, I'll give this choice to someone else. Is there anyone else who is using a computer here? Raise your hand. Anyone who is using a PC? All are using mobiles. Okay, Pradyum, you only ask for a request. Okay. Now you run the program and see. It's already running here. Try to update something else. And if there is any bug, we'll be able to catch that also. Continue. It's up to you what you want to change, what you want to update. Try changing something else also. You had to at least, okay, you can run the program. Wait. Press 2 and see whether it has been changed or not. Rohit Sharma 87.2. Yes, it has been changed. So I hope everybody understood this. Sec. Okay, so I hope everybody understood this. Just raise your hands and
yes, or,
so this is how you have to perform updations. Okay, good. So this is how you have to perform your updations. So updation is a bit tricky. If I just started from the beginning, you can see we had opened the file in the read mode. First of all, what we did was we read everything in a student list. Close the file. Now we searched for the record. We have to search for the record which we are updating. Second, if the record is there, then only perform all this. That is, provide a menu to the user. Okay. It makes, why so much of coding? Because it makes the task easier for the user. Okay. So provide a menu to the user. Provide him a chance to update individual items. He will enter the new value. You have to update that in the matched record. Then replace the old record in student list with the new record. Then dump the updated record into the file. Print record updated successfully. And if suppose your record is not found, then print sorry record doesn't exist. Okay. I'll be sending you this whole program so you can also run it and try to catch the bugs wherever they are. Okay. And try to remove those bugs yourself, right? So we have completed what? Update student. The next is delete student. Can anyone now delete would be, if you have learned update, delete would be all the more very easy to you. Kya karna padega? This whole thing we will be doing except one step. That is, what will change is this part. We will not be doing this. We would be instead deleting the matched record from the file. Whatever record, we will not be doing all this. We will not be providing any update menu to the user. If the record has been found, we are only going to delete it from the outer list and dumping the list back to the file. Can you write the delete student code on your own students? Just try it out right now. in your copies, just write a function for delete. It should be something like this: delete student, and you have to pass roll number. So all the things you have to do, that is, I'll just revise the steps with you, what you need to do. And this is what you have to do. If I have a file, the very first thing is read all records. Where will you read everything? In student list. Fine. Second is search for record. And store that where? Do you need to store anything now? No, you only need to save the record number. That is the index number within the student list of the record which you want to delete. Third is remove matched record from student list. स्टूडेंट लिस्ट से वो वाला रिकॉर्ड हमको बस हटाना है. दैट इज, दिस इज माई स्टूडेंट लिस्ट विच कंटेन्स इंडिविजुअल लिस्ट वेर ईच लिस्ट इज अ रिकॉर्ड इन द फाइल. नाउ सपोज द दिस इज जीरो, दिस इज वन, दिस इज टू, दिस इज थ्री. टू द थर्ड रिकॉर्ड इज द वन विच वी हैव टू डिलीट. सो वॉट वी आर गोइंग टू डू, जस्ट सेव द रिकॉर्ड नंबर ऑफ इट. Right, remove the matched record from the student. How will you remove? You can use the del function. Del, yes, student, and within bracket you will provide mrecno, that is this index number. So what will happen? This record will get deleted from the outer list and it will automatically adjust itself and finally dump the updated student list to file, to the disk file. It's all the more very simple. So let us try it out. So delete student, we will be copying certain statements from here only. That is, this part will be the same. Searching for the record is going to be the same. So copy everything, paste it over here. वही सब कर रहे हैं हम लोग, है ना? Open the file in the read mode, create an empty list student, append every record to the student list, then search for the record. Now in this statement is not required. Only the record number has to be saved. So I will remove this. Print the record. Obviously we have to print the record. Now if m record, now what we need to do next is, after searching for the record, we have to remove matched record from student list. This we have to do. Okay, so for removing this, we have to first check whether mrecno contains something or not. If there is nothing, if it is none, it means that mrecno doesn't contain the matched record index. That means record doesn't exist in the student list. So only when mrecno contains some valid data, do this. Do what? Del student mrecno. Delete the matched record from the student list. Else, record doesn't exist. We have done this, and once this is done, okay. You want to insert the code for updating the file here itself, because we don't need to update the file if the record doesn't exist. Okay, so you can do it here also, but right now for simplicity, because I have divided the program into multiple parts, so that it is easy for everybody to understand. So here I am writing update the file. Okay, or how to update the file? Dump the updated student list to the file. That is also to be done if mrecno contains something. I think we missed it in update. No, we have done everything within the else part only, so no question of that. So here also, only if MREC NO contains something, then only write it to the file. So what to do? We will also copy this part. Open it in which mode? That is the write mode. For record in student, pickle dot dump everything, and also print at the end record updated. Here we will not write updated, record deleted successfully. Okay, so once this is done, it means that the record has been deleted successfully and no need of any other statement over here. Let us run this program and see. First we'll check, it is delete student, so I will copy this from here and I will replace the statement here. But firstly, I need the roll number of the student. So copy this thing. Record is to be deleted. Okay, let's run the program and see. So these are my students. Let us delete record number 4. So I'm going to press 5, enter the roll number. Record deleted successfully, it is giving me, and let's see, yes, it has deleted the 4th record. Next, we'll again try deleting some other student, maybe the 5th one. Yes, 5th has also been deleted. Okay, and let us try to give any roll number which doesn't exist. So we get, sorry, record doesn't exist. So this is how we will be working with it. Okay, so this is how we'll be working with our file. Now, what you, those who can do, I'm giving them one very nice question over here. That is, try to auto-generate roll number. And how you will be auto-generating roll number? Firstly, you will check the file, okay? If the file already contains roll number like this, so the next roll number to be generated should be 6. And in case there is no file, file doesn't exist, it has to be created for the first time. So numbering should start from 1. Aisa hona chahiye. If the file doesn't exist, the number should start from 1. And if already there are some records in the file, it has to generate the exact next roll number. So, ye kaam kaise karna hai? Aap log thoda sochein aur ispe kaam kare, so that next time onwards, when we are asking for the values from the user, user doesn't have to take pains to figure out which roll number he has to enter. Your program should be able to auto-generate unique roll numbers for all the student. Am I clear to everyone? So this is what you need to do for the time being. So all these things I'm telling you with the point of view of your project, and students, please hurry up with your projects now, right? I have given you the time. Any day I will ask for, I'll just set a deadline and I will ask for the project. All of your projects should be ready, okay? So we conclude the class over here. Thank you, everybody.